The key thing is always listening and avoid stereotyping people. And because often I have met people that are first generation and they're very open to the concept of palliative care. And I have met second generation people, they are very gung-ho of not getting into any sort of palliative care at all. And so it is critical to really have the openness to accept what is, you know, what comes across, you know, these meetings and help people to be themselves. They don't have to subscribe to a certain idea from a medical facility, but for them, it is important for them to be heard and for them to understand why we do what we do. Because often we don't have a chance to explain why we do what we do. We often just mention pain and symptom management, but we don't understand, we don't often explain. We do this so they will have quality of life and they have more space for family gatherings and for perhaps even meaning making as they, you know, come towards, you know, the end of one person's journey. And that often is not communicated. So often what I do is to give them that space, to guard that space, so people would have a chance to look beyond the decision making, because it's not about making a decision on an individual. It is about helping somebody to die with dignity.